गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर देशमुख अमोल जगन्नाथ, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ प्लांट पैथोलॉजी, कॉलेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर, नवसारी एग्रीकल्चर यूनिवर्सिटी, वघई, गुजरात. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिलीवर अ लेक्चर इन द कोर्स इंट्रोडक्टरी प्लांट नेमेटोलॉजी ऑफ सेकंड सेमेस्टर BSc ऑनर्स एग्रीकल्चर. द टॉपिक ऑफ द कोर्स इज excretory system and classification of nematodes based on feeding habits. So let us start with the excretory system. First of all, we will discuss what is excretory system. So it is the system in which there is functioning of excrete out the waste from the body of the nematode. The product of the excretory system may be uric acid, may be ammonia, may be peptides or other products which are not useful to the body of nematodes. So let us see about excretory system in detail. So the excretory system is not that much developed in case of nematodes as compared to other animals. It is mainly present in subventral position throughout the nerve ring, which is present on the esophageal sheath. So there are two types of excretory system are present. One is glandular type excretory system and second one is tubular or canalicular type excretory system. So let us discuss both the system in detail. Glandular type of excretory system consists of single specialized cell known as rennet cell. So what is rennet cell? It is a specialized excretory cell of nematode which is useful in the excretion of this excretory product such as peptides, ammonia, amino acids, etc. It is having posteriorly located enlarged gland known as excretory gland or ventral gland. This gland is connected to the excretory pore by a duct known as excretory duct, which is having an opening and it is like a pouch. It is known as ampulla. This type of glandular system is present in the class Adenophorea. So you must have to remember this type of system. Anyone ask about short note on glandular type of system? Second one is tubular or canalicular type of system. So in this system, simply four tubes are present or four canals are present. Two anterior position and two posterior position, and it is having an opening in common through which excreta or waste material is excreted out from the body of nematode. So this type of system is present in the class Cycrinentia. So there are total five types of excretory system are present. One is asymmetrical or trilenchial type. Second one is inverted U-shaped type. Third one is rhabdid type. Fourth one is ascaride type. Fifth one is simple S-shaped or oxyuroid type. So let us discuss one by one in detail. So in case of first system, that is asymmetrical or trilenchial type system, only a single tube is act as an excretory tube which is present throughout the nematode length. It is found in either of the lateral hypodermal cords of the nematode. In the middle, the lumen enlarges and produces or forms a excretory sinus, which is a nucleated structure, and it opens through the anterior canal. It is separate canal produced or separate branch produced, and by which the excreta or waste out is excreted from this. So this type of canalocular type system is asymmetrical one, and that is why it is called as asymmetrical. And second, it is found in the order Tylenchida, that is why the name is Tylenchida type excretory system. Next one is inverted U-shape or cephaloboid type excretory system. In this case, there are only three tubes are present. One present anteriorly and other two are present posteriorly. The anterior canal open outside through excretory pore, and there is no excretory gland is present as that of glandular system. Example is cephalobus, and that is why it is also named as cephaloboid type of excretory system. Then third canalocular type excretory system is rhabditoid type. So there are four cuticularized canal. Two are present anteriorly, two are present posteriorly. Excretory sinus is modified into two excretory glands in between lateral canals, and these glands open ventrally as excretory pore. The example is rhabditis, and that is why this system is called as rhabditoid type of excretory. Then fourth type of excretory system is ascaroid type. It is having four canals, two anterior and two posterior canals. Left anterior canal is short as compared to that of posterior canal. The anterior canal opens in excretory pore located at its tip. Excretory gland cell is also present in ascaroid type of canalocular excretory system. So as it is present in ascaroid type of nematode, it is called as ascaroid type excretory system. So fifth one is simple H-shaped or oxyuroid type. In this excretory system, four tubular canals are present. Two are present laterally in posterior region, two are present laterally in anterior region, and these canals are connected by a swollen excretory sinus. This is swollen structure here, which opens externally as excretory pore. So in simple H-shaped or oxyuroid type excretory system, there is no excretory gland cell is present. Example is oxyurids type of nematode, and that is why name is oxyuroid type excretory system. So dear students, there are also alternate cellular means of excretor system present in the nematodes. So these are hypodermal glands, which enhance efficiency of excretion by functioning throughout the length of body. Then prerectum, it is connection between intestine and rectum. Third one is coelomycetes. So these are the cells which are situated in body cavity or coelom, and these are also act as a alternate means for the excretion. So dear students, anyone ask to describe the excretory system, so you have to describe both the system, glandular system as well as tubular system and their types, as well as you have to mention alternate cellular means of excretion in your exam. So let us see the functions of excretory system. So first function is excretion of toxic substances. Second is secretion of certain type of chemicals. Third one and very important is to maintain osmoregulation in the body of nematode. Fourth one is regulate turgor pressure in body cavity. And in case of one nematode, that is citrus nematode, Tylenculus semipenetrans nematode, excretory pore is located posteriorly. So in all the nematodes, it is present or located anteriorly on ventral or subventral side. In ventral to that of nerve ring, but here it is present or located posteriorly, and it is responsible for the secretion of gelatinous matrix, which bind and protect the eggs from abnormal environmental condition. So you must have to keep in mind this point. In case of citrus nematode or Tylenculus semipenetrans nematode, the excretory system is located posteriorly and which is responsible for secretion of gelatinous matrix, which protects the eggs from abnormal environmental condition. So what are the products of excretory system? So majority waste of the nematode is turned into ammonia. So excretory product or main excretory product of the nematode is ammonia. Secondly, amino acid, peptides, uric acid and fatty acids are also the products of excretory system of nematode. So in your exam, one may ask about excretory product. So you must have to keep in mind all the excretory product. So in this way, you can easily explain the excretory system whichever present in the nematodes. So let us start with nematode feeding habits, in which we will take the example root knot nematodes. So in case of root knot nematode, egg hatching takes place by susceptible host root secretion. The egg liberate second stage larvae or juvenile. The movement of these second stage larvae was done towards host roots. So nematode exploration occur. So what is exploration? It is nothing but the position of the nematode, or nematode occupy the position for feeding purpose. Insertion of stylet of the nematode takes place inside the host cell. There is injection or secretion of dorso esophageal gland occurs, which secretes saliva, which are useful for dissolving the cell wall of the roots. Ingestion of host cytoplasm is also occurred. So at that point, retraction of the stylet from the host cell occurs. So here the biochemical reaction occur between nematode secretion and cell sap. So actually interaction between host and nematode occurs, and which result to two things. One is hypertrophy and second one is hyperplasia. So what is hypertrophy? It is nothing but the cell elongation, where hyperplasia, it is nothing but division of cells. So due to which there is formation of gall or knot occurs. So this is all about nematode feeding habit of root knot nematode. Like root knot nematode, all the nematodes are responsible for causing different types of symptoms. The process remains more or less similar to that of root knot nematodes. So let us see with figure. So here it is a female, it lay eggs, and whenever root exudates occur at that site, the juvenile will take birth. So juvenile second attracts toward the root behind the root tip. It acts as a endophytes. It penetrates into the cortex or vascular system of the host plant. They remain sessile in the vascular or cortex system, and then they feed at that position. So at that position, the dorsoesophageal gland of this nematode secretes enzymes or some of the polysaccharides or other molecules. Also, the host plant stimulation occurs, and due to the host plant stimulations and nematode infestation, there is interaction between nematode and the host cell occurs, which results into hypertrophy of the cell or hyperplasia of the cell, and which result into the gall or knot production. And after that, the particular juvenile second is converted into juvenile 3. At this stage, the stylet is not there, that is why these are not infective. Sexual differentiation occurs in case of J3 stage, and then they convert into a female as well as male. So female is larger, it attains pear shape or other shapes, while male attains a vermiform shape. So male cannot infect, but female goes to egg laying, and then further the cycle will repeated again and again, and 7 to 8 generation occurs as we have discussed in earlier lecture. So this is all about the feeding habit of this root knot nematode. So according to feeding habits, the nematodes wear classification in different groups. That's why we have studied here what is actually feeding habit is, or how the infestation of these nematodes occurs. So let us discuss the classification. Before going to classification, we will see the difference between galls and the nodules. So what is galls? These are formed within the root. These are nodules are formed on the side of root. Galls are irregular in shape, nodules are regular in shape. Galls are very hard, nodules are very soft. Galls are harmful, nodules are useful. Galls are not easily detachable from the host root, nodules are easily detachable from the host root. Nematodes are found after dissection of galls, while bacteria are found after dissection of these nodules. Pinkish color fluid not seen in case of galls after dissection. After dissection, pinkish color fluid seen in case of nodule. And galls are not responsible for fixing atmospheric nitrogen, while nodules are fixed or responsible to fix atmospheric nitrogen. So nodules are useful one and it is harmful one. So in your exam, anyone ask the difference between galls and nodules, or nodes and nodules. So you have to give the difference with figure. You may draw. So let us go to the classification of plant parasitic nematode based on feeding habits. So there are two major classes. One is above ground feeder, second one is below ground feeder. So in case of above ground feeder, there are again two different types. One type is feeding on flower buds, leaves and bulbs. Second type is feeding on tree trunk. So there are different examples are there, we will see one by one. So in case of feeding on flower buds, leaves and bulbs, first example is seed gall nematode, so in which grains are replaced by hard brown black seed galls which contain thousands of dry nematode. So seed gall nematode or Anguina triticae is one of the most useful example of this seed gall nematode. Second one is leaf and bud nematode, that is Aphalancoides basi. So it acts as a foliar nematode or foliar blight nematode, leaf blight nematode of the chrysanthemum, which causes browning of chrysanthemum leaves infested with Aphalancoides redzema bossi. Third example is stem and bulb nematode, Dytelenchus dipsacki. So here it is occurred in case of bulb present in garlic. So the basal plate of garlic bulb severely infested with this stem and bulb nematode, and which is appear to be rotted and can be easily separated from the bulbs. So these all are the example of nematodes which are feeding on flower, leaves and bulbs. Second type of above ground feeder nematodes are those feeding on tree trunk. So let us see the example. One example is red ring nematode, that is Rhodanophalancus coccophyllus, and second one is pine wilt nematode, Pursa phalancus xylophyllus. So this is a red ring nematode which produces a red ring in tree trunk. Well, second example is pine wilt nematode, Bursa phalancus xylophyllus. So there is development of the disruption of sap ascent occurred due to tracheal embolism or cavitation, followed by wilting of whole plant in the pine. So this is all about the tree trunk nematode, that is red ring and pine wilt nematode. So dear students, in exam anyone ask about above ground feeder nematode, so you just have to enlist these two types with explaining or giving example and explain what is the infestation or symptoms they cause in the plants. So second type of nematodes are below ground feeder nematode. They are again classified into three classes. One is endoparasitic nematode, second one is semi endoparasitic nematode, and third one is ectoparasitic nematode. So the name itself indicates where they are feeding. So first, endoparasitic. So endoparasitic means inside host plant. Semi endoparasitic means outside as well as inside, that is one third portion of the body is present inside the host plant while two third body present outside the host plant system, whether it may be root, stem, flower, tree trunk, etc. Then third one is ectoparasitic nematode. So ectoparasitic nematode is nothing but the nematodes which are feeding externally to that of host plant cell. So let us start with endoparasitic nematodes. So what is endoparasitic nematode? The entire nematode is found inside the root, and the major portion of the nematode body found inside the plant tissue. Then these types of nematodes are called as endoparasitic nematodes. So there are two types of endoparasitic nematodes. One is migratory endoparasite and second one is sedentary endoparasite. So what is migratory? Migratory means the movement of that particular nematode occurs from one place to another place. So what is sedentary? So literal meaning of sedentary is nothing but the sessile nematode, or the nematode which remain at one position. They do not move from that position to another place. It is called as sedentary endoparasite. So there are different types of migratory endoparasite as well as sedentary endoparasite. So here student, you must keep the example of these nematodes with their type of infestation. So here first example is Leysen nematode, that is Pratelenca species. It is example of migratory endoparasite. So it is an endoparasite which is migratory, which move from one place to another place within the root system and produces lesions. Second one is burrowing nematode. Example is Rhadopolis similis or Rhadopolis species. It is again migratory endoparasite. Then third one is rice root nematode, Hirse manniella species. It is also migratory endoparasite. Then second type of nematodes are sedentary endoparasitic nematodes. So in this case, the second stage larvae or juvenile second penetrate the rootlets and become sedentary throughout the life cycle at that place. Examples are Heterodera species, that is cyst nematode, and Melodogyne species, that is root knot nematode. So here it is the cyst nematode, it is the female of this cyst nematode. Second one is root knot nematode, Melodogyne, and it is the female of this nematode. So dear students, you must have to keep in remembrance of the example of this all the type of endoparasitic nematodes, whether it is migratory endoparasites or sedentary endoparasites. Then there are again different types of nematodes. It is semi endoparasitic nematode. So what is semi endoparasitic? 1/3 part is in the host tissue, while 2/3 part is outside the host tissue. So the anterior part of the nematode, head and neck being permanently fixed in the cortex or vascular system, and the posterior part extends free into the soil. Examples are Rotulinculus species, that is reniform nematode. Here you can see the semi endoparasitic nature of this nematode. This is the female of this nematode. Then second one is Tyrannculus semi penetrans. So second type of nematode are ectoparasitic nematodes. So these nematodes live freely in the soil and move closely or on the root surface, feed intermittently on the epidermis and root hair near the root tip. They are of two types. One is migratory ectoparasite, second is sedentary endoparasite, ectoparasite. So these nematodes, migratory ectoparasites, are the nematodes spend their entire life cycle free in the soil, feeding externally on the host plant, deposit eggs in the soil. When the roots are disturbed, they detach themselves. Examples are Crickae, Nemoids, and Pratelenca species. Sedentary ectoparasite, in this type of parasitism, the attachment of nematode occurs to the root system permanent. But for this, it is similar to the previous one. That is migratory ectoparasites. That is, whenever the roots are disturbed, they detach themselves from the host plants. So examples are Hemicyclophora arenaria and Trichodera species. So here some of the sedentary ectoparasite, that is Hemicyclophora sith nematode. Second one is stubby root nematode, Trichodera species, sedentary ectoparasite. While in case of migratory ectoparasite, ring nematode, Trichonemela species, which is excretory or migratory ectoparasite, which is feed externally and migrate throughout the root system. So here are some of the examples of this ectoparasitic and endoparasitic nematodes. So sedentary endoparasite, spiral nematode. Spiral nematode is nothing but Helicotylenchus species. Migratory ectoparasite, dagger nematode, Zipinema species. Sedentary endoparasite, root knot nematode, Melodogyne species. Migratory endoparasite, Lesen nematode, Pratelenchus species. Then ectoparasites, Reniform nematode, Rotelenchus species. So here are also, there are figure which indicates clearly that there are different types of ecto as well as endoparasitic nematode. So dear student, you must have to keep in mind all the examples, because examples are too much important as far as exam is concerned. Even in case of ICAR, JRF, SRF or NET and ARS exams, these types of examples can be asked, especially cyst nematode and root knot nematode. These are sedentary endoparasitic nematode. You must have to keep in mind. So dear friends, let us see some of the important nematodes. So I have given here the list of nematodes which are very important one. So the logic behind giving this important nematode with generic and common name is that we have observed different types of nematodes. The common name of these nematodes are based on feeding habits or on the basis of their morphological features. So you must have to keep in mind all these nematodes, their common name and scientific name. And in our next lecture, we are going to discuss the classification of the nematode on the basis of taxonomy, their morphological feature. So you must have to keep in mind all the nematode species or genus in your remembrance. So first one is Anguna species, seed and leaf wall nematode. Second one is Aphelonchoida species, bud and leaf nematode, or it is called as foliar nematode. Balanolema species, sting nematode. Trichonema species, ring nematode. Trichonemela species, ring nematode. So you see Trichonema, ring. Trichonemela, ring. Dictylenchus species, stem and bulb nematode. Globodera, so global shape means round shape. So Globodera species is called as round cyst nematode or golden nematode. Helicotylenchus species, spiral nematode. Heterodera species, cyst nematode. Hemicryconemide species, false cyst nematode. Hemicyclophora, cyst nematode. Hoplolemus, lance nematode. Longidurus, needle nematode. Paralongidurus, needle nematode. Pratelenchus, Lesen nematode. Paratelenchus, pin nematode. Rotelenculus, reniform nematode. Rotelenchus, spiral nematode. So here you can see the difference. Paratelenchus, pin nematode. Pratelenchus, Lesen nematode. So there is little bit difference. Rotelenculus and Rotelenchus, reniform nematode, spiral nematode. So in this way you have to keep in mind. Nacova species, false root knot nematode. Paratrichodorus, stubby root knot nematode. रेडोपोलस बरोइंग निमेटोड, जीपिनेमा स्पेसिस डैगर निमेटोड, बुर्सा फेलनकस कोकोफिलस कोकोनट पाम निमेटोड और रिंग रेड रिंग निमेटोड, बुर्सा फेलनकस जाइलोफिलस पाइन वुड विल्ट निमेटोड। सो दीज ऑल स्पेसिस विथ देयर कॉमन नेम एंड साइंटिफिक नेम मस्ट बी कीप इन माइंड सो दैट इट इज यूजफुल इन नंबर ऑफ एग्जाम्स, whether it is competitive exam or it is semester end exam or midterm exam. Anyone ask match the pair or directly, that is Paratelenchus nematode is known as fill in the blanks. You have to write pin nematode, Paratelenchus lesion nematode likewise. So dear students, here there are number of important nematode genera which are with their generic name, species name and common name. Even a single genus, it is having different species and it is having different common name. So just see, Aphalanchoides species is there. If species is Redzema bossi, then it is Chrysanthemum foliar nematode. If it is Aphalanchoides basi, then it is white tip foliar nematode in rice. So Dytelenchus dipsacki stem and bulb nematode. If it is Dytelenchus myceliophagus, it is mushroom nematode. If it is Dytelenchus angustus, it is Oophora stem nematode. In case of Melodogyne arenaria peanut root knot nematode. Melodogyne graminicola, rice root knot nematode. Melodogyne hapla, northern root knot nematode. Melodogyne incognita, southern root knot nematode. Melodogyne javanica, Javanese root knot nematode. I have enlisted out these species because in number of your SAR competitive exams, the particular genus is asked with their species for the common name, and that is why you must have to keep in mind, because all these are important genus of the nematode which can be asked in your exam, specially Melodogyne, Heterodera, Globodera, Dytelenchus, Aphalanchoides, as well as Trichodorus, Rotelenchus, etc. So let us see some of the economically important nematodes which are associated with the crops in India. So first one is root knot nematode. So all the species of these root knot nematodes are present in India, that is Melodogyne incognita, southern root knot nematode, Melodogyne javanica, Melodogyne arenaria, Melodogyne graminicola and Melodogyne indica, reniform nematode, cyst nematode, lesion nematode, white tip nematode, Oophora nematode, burrowing nematode, citrus nematode, potato cyst nematode, wheat seed coil nematode, rice root nematode, stunt nematode. So these all are the very very important nematodes which are present in the India, and they are infesting the crop of India and causes too much losses in India. So these all are the nematode species which are too much important, and in our course we must have to study the morphology of at least these nematode genus in detail, and that is why I am stating here that you must have to keep the name of all these genus with their species and common name, so that it is very useful in next lecture. So thank you so much for attending this class. So if you have any suggestion or you got any mistake, you please write comment in the comment box. Please subscribe the channel so that all the other series of lectures you can easily get on your YouTube. Thank you so much.